Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use MongoDB Atlas with Spring Boot and Angular. I have two sample projects. I'm going to show all details on that projects. And MongoDB Atlas is a cloud database service. You can deploy and manage your database on AWS, Azure, or GCP. I already created an account and I choose the GCP options. You can use that. I will not show that part. You can read the documentation and create a MongoDB Atlas with any of these options. But I will show how to connect to your application. Let's open the application first. And open the README. I have some use cases. The first option is logged in with Gmail. I configured the UI part, login with Firebase. It's a Google Cloud Services also you can use. And you can create a free account and then get the API keys and use. And after that, user can see all the posts. He can or she can add any posts. And we can delete the post. We can add any comments. Also, we have a small personal page is a dashboard for user and a chart. The MongoDB Atlas has an option to create a chart and embed in your application. It's really good. And I just create a simple chart and embed it in our application. And you can find all other details how to run the project and which API is there. And of course, this project is just a sample. You can improve it. Our API call is not secure. Since we are using the Firebase, we can use Firebase token and secure our application to make call with Firebase token. And also, now we are getting all the posts. This can be lazy loading or pagination. And also comments. For comments, I will show. Now we don't have option to edit or delete. And the chart options also is a simple chart we have to update maybe and some other UI changes. And let's go to the resources and see how we can connect to MongoDB Atlas. First, we have to go to the MongoDB Atlas. And after creating a project, you can see the cluster. And here you can see the connect options and connect with your application. By default is Node.js and you can choose any other version. We are using Java Spring Boot. And let's check the Java and select any version and just copy this part. Before that, you need to create a username to access this database with the password and save this password. And I have a post user. This is my user and I will update this part, just copy this and go to the Spring Boot application and open the properties. For now, replace this part with your URI. And if you have another database name, just change this database name. If you go with production, you can update this production option also. And for this, I don't have any changes. Let's open the services, which service we have. I have a REST controller. Let's check this REST controller. We can get all posts by user email. And we can get all the posts. Also, we can save it. We can add a comment with post ID. And we can delete. Or we can update. This is all our options. And also in the Bootstrap, I have a loader class. And then if you want to run something on startup application, for example, you want to insert some data to database, you can use this class and insert. If you open that one, you will add some post. I will not do that. Gonna comment this part and the configuration part. This is for calling the API to disable these filters. Otherwise, you will get error on the same server. And our entities, we have a post entity. I add some validations. If you want to validate your structure, you can add this JavaX validation and validate your structure. And we have author of the post, and we have list of command, and we have user, blah blah. If you go here, it's same date, content, and other details. And we have a simple repository. This repository extend Mongo repository. And for that, you need only add this dependency, the MongoDB dependencies. That's it. And after that, and we have two services. After that, just go to the main class and run the main class. Run it. The application is failed. Okay, let's check it. It says requires authentication. I think we are using this is correct, but I think we start with profile dev. Okay, let's restart. Okay, by default it choose the application properties, but now we have two profiles, we have to give the profiles. In here we don't have username and password, that's why it fails. Okay, now API is ready. Let's go to the UI part. As I told, this is a simple Spring Boot first one. This is Angular project, and let's go to the services. We have post service. Okay, we have this simple class, and all our API is calling here. We have observable Rx Java extension, and we are calling our APIs via this method. And we have components, sign in and post, the others you can check it. And there is something important I want to show, and if you open the readme you can see how to run. Okay, the important part, you need to create a Firebase application with Google Cloud, and you have to update your key with this API key and domain, the other stuff. If you go to the Firebase give you these options, you just copy paste and change the environment variable, and where is it, here, and you have to go to this class and update these variables with your API keys. That is the option you can do. And something else I can show here. Okay, let's start the application first. Okay, let's say md serve h-o. Also, let's go to close and click the collections. Let's see if we have any collection. We have a post, but it's empty now. Zero. And okay, it started, and we have an option to log in with Google. Click sign in, and I'm gonna sign with this user. Okay, as you see now we don't have any posts, it's completely empty, and some profile info. And this is the chart which I created. It's just I create a chart and add this frame to our application. That's it. Nothing is different. And let's create a post. Let's say, how is Mongo? Let's press save. Okay, I have a post. And I have an option to delete or delete, edit. And let's do this. Capital. Say Mongo Atlas. Okay, it's updated. And I can add a comment, but I don't want to do that. Let's log out and log in with another user. Login. Okay. I can see post, but I cannot edit or delete. It's not my post. And face. Fine. Edit. And I add one comment. I want to add another subject. Other post. I save it. Now I have an option to delete or edit. For comment, for now we don't have this option. We can add it to edit or delete, same functionality. It's almost same. We just need to update the UI part and call the API to delete or edit the comment. And let's go profile. Now I think the chart, yes, two content is there, but this is since I didn't test it. I have to add maybe some more advanced query to change this part. Now it's very simple. Just show the how many content we have. And also let's log out and sign in. I think we use that user. Okay. I add a new post comment and I can delete my post. Gone. Okay, this is also mine. I already deleted my post. That is what I want to show you. You can create a simple application and connect to the MongoDB Atlas.